Argon.
Argon.
I have, so I come up.
Wow.
Well, it's our own fault for playing all this.
Yeah.
Yep.
Pick on healthy people.
I like to hear Mr. Nest play too.
Who is that?
Horace.
Horace.
Is he still living?
Oh, yeah.
Abe Horton, you ever heard of him?
Who?
Abe Horton.
I heard that sizable man.
Yep.
Off of Parkway, weren't he somewhere?
Yeah, yep.
He used to play on, over at Free for Square Days.
Oh, yeah, fancy, yep, there was a big square night.
Yeah, too.
And they'd have, in summertime, like two rings are getting all fit.
Well, they played the Freeze, I mean, Fancy Gap.
Yep, years and years.
About 15, 20 years.
Well, they played at, Rookin's Building at the Parkview.
Yeah.
For a long time.
Used to be a good dance so far. Royal Sax would call the dance.
Did he die?
Royal?
Sizable?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know he had a gap stroke.
Big study.
Tom Norman.
Yeah, he played the banjo with the Royal Sax.
And Michael.
Thanks, I thought he didn't take me to see.
He wanna play the mandolin?
Yeah.
Well, you gonna?
Barbara Poole played with Ben Weaver and Richard Bowman. Barbara Poole used to play with Whit Sizemore.
You didn't know that?
And Chester McDowell.
You know Nichols?
I don't know if Nichols played.
He's a picture of him in the name.
Yeah, but not with.
Chester McDowell, type Ben Weaver plays.
Right.
How old's Chester, you reckon? He learned? He's teaching everybody how to play music. He must not, he must be older than what he was back here.
He can't just hold it tight.
Can't many people up at you? Except me, I'm getting there. I feel like I'm getting there.
He may be over there. He's been around so long.
I'd say about 75.
That's reasonable.
Yeah, probably.
Those two are as healthy as goats, so they're gonna outlive everybody anyway, so they're gonna talk about all the people they used to play with.
Yeah, they can see it's fun to do that. It's fun for us.
Yeah.
Yeah, they used to play, what was the fiddle player in that team? Out on Parkway.
That's right.
What was it, fight over?
Y'all have air conditioning in the house?
Yes.
They ain't used it yet, though, what about that? Jack.
Got windows open now.
Now we don't. Now I'm kidding. We have ceiling fans and.
Well, I follow a mechanic one time, and you know, people back there might not pay you, they wouldn't have any money. So one time I was with David, David said, you wanna go with me to see if I can collect, so we went. And a lot of houses down East Park, North Carolina, you had to go down a lane, they'd be way back by the woods, and it was a little black man. And we're going to, most times you go there, if they see you coming, you won't find it. This black guy, he was walking down this old dirt path, and he stopped, and that's who it was. And Daddy was talking to him, he didn't have any, he didn't get any money out. But I looked at the house over there, it was hot like the day, mosquitoes there, and he had all the windows closed up just tight, and the doors, everything. I said, what you got all the windows? I said, don't y'all burn up in that place? He said, yeah, mighty hot, but it's better than all them mosquitoes. They didn't have those screens on the window.
Oh, yeah.
And they had that thing tight. It was all closed up, the windows, the doors, everything. How they stayed in there, I don't know.
guys?
You can't get them off the batteries.
It might be like me, though, too old.
Some of the collars have died, you know.
Huh?
A lot of the collars have died.
They,
Collars
and,
water.
Yeah. I think maybe it's part of they have a dance they try to. And they've been trying to have a dance on Saturday night, Freeze. Is anybody been there to see if it's any, I mean, who plays it, or is they doing dance?
Yeah, used to go where you couldn't even get a seat in the Freeze up there. Yeah. That's where he met Ellen.
Yeah. Well,
my wife asked about y'all.
Yeah.
Last time I ever see you. I said, I wasn't alive.
That's why their marriage lasted so long. Ever since he's up here in the camper, she's down there.
She stayed up there about 20 years, though. Most people up there, they'll just come and stay a weekend or a couple weeks.
Yes, yeah.
But me and Marge stayed the whole time. And I told them, I said, they said, why don't you? I said, we stayed the whole time. Plus, we was in this little camper with a fiddle, squawking every night. She did something to her mind.
South Carolina was looking good or good or whatever.
She said, she told me she didn't want to stay home and go to her own church and all.
Well, why didn't you buy a place up here?
Well, I just about did a time or two. We went over to Freeze one time, the man gave us a list. Up here on the highway. So we went way down, like you go through Freeze, you know, going out to the other road coming, you turn to the right, go back, like for that school highway where they have a filter. Yeah. We turned down in there.
Wow.
And there's some sort of new houses, weren't real either, but they let them go apart. I went down there, I said, Margaret, is this house we should buy here is an empty brick house? She said, why not? She give me a bad look. I said, you see that goat in the yard? We wouldn't even have the motor.
Oh, yeah.
That's a goat. Tied in the tarpy.
Well, now, the boy that rents my mama's house has about 48 goats, and I want her to borrow a couple of them and let them eat that bacon. I don't want to,
That's a really good idea.
I mean, I really want to borrow some goats.
Somebody ought to rent their goats out.
Yeah.
I think that's a good idea. They go someplace.
I know a guy that does
that. Does he really?
He cleans up country patches.
They'll eat that mess, huh?
You know, put a fence in, he'll put 40 goats in a
place.
They pay him to feed his goats.
But I want one that coyotes can't kill. I want the big old horned one. I don't want the little baby one.
You don't want to carry a knife.
A badden. I want two baddens. That's what I want.
Hey, you got to write that song.
When I was a kid, Dad called. I go, it's about that high. And he had horns out. And bought a scaled down model of a regular wagon. One horse wagon.
Forget the bull.
Had chains on it. And you can work that goat just like you would a horse.
Yeah, people used to have goat wagons. You used to see pictures of them. Yeah.
We'd haul apples out of the mountain.
He's got some that look like it weigh about 150 pounds, ain't lying.
Yeah, that song got a verse in it. Dad's going to buy you a billy goat. That goat won't butt, they're going to take you to a chitlin' strip. People don't know what you're talking about.
Well, I don't want one of the coyotes are going to kill, and I'd have to replace it. I want a bad gnarly horns on him.
Some of them will attack you. You gotta be careful. You know, you should be what happened. You don't want to go through their yard.
Yeah, I'll put my dogs. Big golden retriever, lick you to death. He's 100 pounds of nothing. You know, Jack Russell, he's all around you, lick him. So.
Thank you.
might sing it, Jack.
What?
I thought you might sing it.
I can think of one. I've heard of it.
Chitlin' Cookin' Time in Cheetah County.
Chitlin' Cookin' Time in Cheetah County.
They have a chitlin' thing down in Bamberg, South Carolina. It's a little short of either way to that one. You will find them in the Chitlin' Festival.
And they works to it. I said, what is the guy doing?
I've been cracking cornbread and it's right good too.
Contestants.
Oh.
Or contestants. Scrape dogs and something and they chop them up.
Fry them.
Somebody thinks it's dogs.
What's in a new dough? It ain't nothing but hog intestines. I mean, stuff.
Yeah, that's nasty.
Wait, it's Chitlin' Cookin' Time in Cheatham County. I'll be courting in the Cheatham County Hills. Pick up Cheatham County Chitlin' Cooker. I have a longing that the chitlins will fill.
It's not like you can sing yet.
You'd sing that on part where they wouldn't even know
what to do. I heard that always marry an ugly girl.
It doesn't fit in that song.
No, but it's a good song. Yeah. She can cook the chitlins.
Yeah, right.
So the old people, they ate everything. They're back. You know,
everything but swill.
I've eaten crack.
I have.
Cracking
like cornbread's good.
Cracking cornbread, for real, that's real good.
We kill pigs for you.
Pig feet.
I had my grandma live with me. She,
South Beach.
She kept it, further down the food chain. And I guess they just grew up poorly, as you say.
No wonder we all got cholesterol at home. The old people, they take this cracker and grind them up like in a sausage grinder and make a big ball, like a big ball of fat. You come home to school and slide off a piece of it. It couldn't give you high cholesterol.
There's a quiet and peaceful country in Middle Tennessee. You can find it in the book they call Geography. Made famous by its farming, its mining, and its stills, there's always Chitlin' cooking in those Cheetah cabins.
Oh, I love it.
When they're cooking them things, boil them. Sometimes they boil them all before they fry them. But they don't smell too good. To me, some people like
it. When I killed the hogs, my granny said all she'd eat for supper was apple sauce.
All the good things have been put before me. I think chitlins are the best. When I press that dying pillow, let chitlins be my last request.
If you learn, you can sing that for a folk song.
Yeah.
I don't believe it's copyrighted. It might be.
That's a tongue twister.
That's great. That is great.
I can't remember songs like that. She can remember.
All right.
When was the last time you heard that?
No.